Hello everyone and welcome. On 14th of July last month, UKPSC conducted the prelims examination for upper PCS. The results are expected to be out soon. Provisional answer keys are already out. And as per UKPSC's official calendar, 16th November is the start date for mains examination. So this gives us around 3 to 3.5 months to prepare all the subjects for mains examination. The purpose of today's video is just that. We'll look into how to prepare art and culture for UKPSC mains examination 2024. Before starting, there is certain thing that you should know. There has been a change of pattern this year. Examination pattern mein changes aaye hain, official notification. Aap sabhi ne padhi hogi, to you all know ki there has been some changes. Now we filed an RTI to UKPSC regarding just that, ki what were the changes or what kind of pattern that we can expect in this exam, this year's examination. So as per their official reply, they said ki samanya adhyayan ke samast prashn patron hetu prashnon ki sanrachna nimnlikhit prakar ki hogi. That means the questions will be framed in these three ways. Theek hai, first we will have ati laghu utariya question, second we will have laghu utariya questions, and third we have vistrat utariya. Matlab we have first short answer, very short answer type questions, then short answer, then we have long answer type questions. Focus of today's video is art and culture. Now art and culture, as you all know, it is a part of this year, it is a part of GS1. GS1 ka jo paper hoga, art and culture bhi usi ka ek part hai. Now art and culture is kind of a very neglected subject. The reason being ki it is vast, it is considered very vast by many students, and second it is also considered complex. Ki thoda sa complex bhi hai, thoda sa vast bhi, isko students ko lagta hai ki vast bhi hai. So the thing is ki art and culture is not prepared well by many of the students, but that is not the case in art and culture. Art and culture, you have to understand ki ek bahut hi scoring subject hai. It is a very scoring subject if you know how to prepare it. Agar aapko pata hai ki kaise prepare karna hai, to it is a scoring subject, and also it is very much relevant with other exam, other subjects also. Ki aur jo baki ke paper, hamare papers hote hain, baki subjects hote hain, for example art and culture can be cited. The examples from art and culture can be cited in various subjects like ethics pe aap use kar sakte hain, society ke paper mein uska use ho sakta hai, aise mein you can use various examples from art and culture. So that makes art and culture first a very important subject for our mains examination, and also a very interesting subject. So we'll have to prepare, we'll have to devise a strategy in such a way ki hum easily usko cover kar sakein ek limited time frame mein, and usko hum easily mark bhi kar sake. Means we can easily achieve marks in this subject. Now moving on, the first thing that we have to see is the syllabus for the examination. Ki what is the syllabus that is given by UKPSC for art and culture? So the syllabus says ki Indian culture will cover the salient aspect of art forms, literature and architecture from ancient to modern times. तो इस सिलेबस से हमें क्या पता चलता है? फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज गिवन इज द टाइम पीरियड दैट इज एंशिएंट टू मॉडर्न. Ancient to modern means it will go from Harappan civilization right to the British era. British era, Harappan civilization se leke British era tak ka hamare paas time period hai, and ki all the history, and we have to read various art forms like music or dances or paintings, and then literature, for example Sanskrit literature, Pali literature, Prakrit literature, then medieval period mein Persian literature, and architecture again right from the Harappan period to the modern period. So this is the syllabus that is given by UKPSC for the examination. Now before moving into a strategy on how to prepare for the examination, the first thing that we have to do is we have to look at what kind of questions were being asked by UKPSC in the previous examination. Previous jo examinations hue hain UKPSC ke, jo pichle mains hue hain, वहाँ पे क्या क्या किस तरीके से क्वेश्चन पूछे आए हैं, किस टॉपिक से क्वेश्चन पूछे गए हैं, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर देयर, वेदर दे आर डायरेक्ट, वेदर दे आर इनडायरेक्ट, ये सारी चीजें हम देखनी हमें पड़ेगी. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी लुक इनटू द पेपर ऑफ 2012 का पेपर देखते हैं. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर इज व्हाट इज वेदांगा. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन कम्स डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम लिटरेचर वाला पार्ट. लिटरेचर सब सेक्शन में संस्कृत लिटरेचर में वेदांगा, इट्स अ वेरी डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट पार्ट. सेकंड क्वेश्चन, distinguish between alwars and nainas. Now this question is from religion wala topic, and religion wale topic mein bhi it comes from bhakti movement sub topic. So religion mein jo bhakti movement sub topic hai, wahan se ye question hamara pucha gaya hai. Distinguish between the alwars and nainas. Third question, discuss the syadavada theory in jainism. Syadavada theory in Jainism, as we can see ki ek aur question, this question comes from religion. This again comes from religion. Ki religion jo topic hai, wahan se ye question bhi frame kiya hua hai. And the last question in this paper, bring out the salient features of Ellora's Kailasha temple. Ellora's Kailasha temple, bring out the salient features. This question comes from temple architecture. Architecture mein, when we study temple architecture, toh wahan se this question has been directly framed by the commission. Now, moving on, the next exam was conducted in 2016. The next examination jo hua tha, 2016 mein hua tha. Toh wahan pe art and culture ke, these were the questions. Who was Bhaskaracharya? The first question. Now, this question comes from literature section mein bhi hum include kar sakte hain isko. Scientific literature mein, he is a writer of a mathematical treatise, he was a mathematician, or we can also include it in scientific personalities of ancient India. Scientific personality wala jo subsection aa jata hai hamara, to us topic se we can see ki ye question frame kiya gaya tha. Second question is, who was the propagator of Advaitism? This question again is from religion. Religion se ye question bhi religion se pucha gaya hai. ठीक है, रिलीजन में भी भक्ति मूवमेंट वाला जो पार्ट है वहां से दिस क्वेश्चन हैज बीन फ्रेम, अ वेरी डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन अगेन. थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज, डिस्क्राइब द ओरिजिनल टीचिंग्स ऑफ बुद्धा. दिस क्वेश्चन अगेन इज फ्रॉम रिलीजन. बुद्धिज्म से डायरेक्ट एक क्वेश्चन पूछा हुआ है एंड इट इज अ 250 वर्ड क्वेश्चन, मींस इट इज अ 16 मार्कर एज पर द ओल्ड मार्किंग स्कीम. दिस इज अ 16 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन. तो डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन है अगेन, describe the original teachings of Buddha. So again we can see ki religion wala jo topic hai wahan se ye question bhi hame pucha gaya hai. Moving on, then we have the next paper which was conducted last year of UKPSC upper BCS 2021 ka jo paper tha, 2023 mein conduct kiya gaya tha. So first question yahan pe jo hai, what was the Sufi movement? Okay, so this question and the second question, look at this. Why did the Chisti silsila became so popular in India? Discuss. Now as you can see, both these questions are from a same topic, that is Sufism, or Sufism which makes a part again of religion. So religion ke andar Sufism sub topic jo aata hai wahan par se hamare dono hi question frame hue hain. And look at these questions, they are very direct question. What was the Sufi movement and why did the Chisti silsila became so popular in India? Third question, examine the contribution of Mughal rulers in the field of art and architecture. थर्ड क्वेश्चन कम्स फ्रॉम मेडिवल पीरियड. मेडिवल पीरियड में मुगल पीरियड डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन पूछा हुआ है कि मुगल्स एंड देयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, मुगल रूलर्स एंड देयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ आर्ट एंड आर्किटेक्चर. सो अगेन वी कैन सी कि डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन है, तीनों ही रिलीजन से भी क्वेश्चन आया है. यू कैन सी फर्स्ट के दो क्वेश्चन है, दे आर फ्रॉम रिलीजन एंड दिस वन इज फ्रॉम आर्किटेक्चर वाला पार्ट. नाउ मूविंग ऑन, एज यू कैन सी if we compare art and culture ka jo weightage hai as per pure exam 200 marks ka exam hota tha, usme jab hum pure ko comparison karte hain to art and culture, the weightage of art and culture has never broken this mark. 20% se upar you can see 2012 mein bhi nahi aaya hai, 2016 mein bhi nahi aaya hai, aur 2021 mein bhi it is not even 10% in 2021. So we can see ki weightage of art and culture is not very high, utna zyada high nahi hai, very limited, it is not even going 20% in the last 3 examinations conducted by the UKPSC. So 20% of 200 is 40, so we can expect here 40 marks it is not touched, it has not even touched in the last 3 examinations. So we can expect ki haan, the weightage will remain below 40. The weightage of art and architecture will remain below 40. Now this is a very important fact ki jo uska weightage hai wo 40 marks ke kam hi rahega, 40 marks ke niche hi rahega if we look into the previous three examinations conducted by UKPSC. Theek hai, so we will have to devise our strategy based on that. Now we already discussed ki yaar pattern change ho chuka hai, UKPSC has changed its pattern. Ab jo uska syllabus hai, that is very similar to what is asked in UPPCS also, and UPSC also has the same syllabus given. Now, to prepare well for this examination, we are going to set our benchmark of UPPCS. Hum UPPCS ko as a benchmark leke chalte hain ki let's say in case it happens ki the paper UKPSC जो पेपर कंडक्ट करेगा, इफ लेट्स से दे इंक्रीज द लेवल, तो वहां पे अगर वो एक लेवल इंक्रीज कर देते हैं तो वी हैव टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड. सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक यूपीपीसीएस का जो पेपर है that as a benchmark, and we'll have to prepare accordingly. We'll have to prepare our strategy accordingly. Before going into that strategy, again, we will look into what kind of questions are asked in UPBCS examination also. UPBCS examination mein kis tarike ke question puch rahe hain, we'll look into that. There are few questions from last 4-5 years ka jo mains hua hai UPBCS ka, wahan se kuch questions hai hamare paas. For example, first question is, describe the role of Buddhist literature in creation of world peace. Now, contrary to what is being asked in Uttarakhand PCS mein, they are asking direct questions. Here, look at this question. Describe the role of Buddhist literature in creation of world peace. Now, this is not a direct question at all. You have to apply some thinking into it. Aapko sochna padega isko likhne ke liye. First, you have to know what is the demand of the question. Then you have to apply your knowledge of Buddhist literature and how it can help in creation of world peace. So, pehla hi question jo hamara dikh gaya, that is quite different from what is being asked in Uttarakhand PCS. Theek hai? Second question dekhte hain. Write a note on town planning of Harappan civilization period. Look at this question. Again, direct question hai. When we study Harappan civilization, there is a whole topic on their town planning. So directly humne wahan se question utha ke pooch liya hai. Theek hai? Nothing very typical about that. Third question pe aate hain. Third question says, discuss the scientific aspect of Indian cultural heritage. Now, this is again a very important question. Kyun? Kyunki this is again not direct. Direct question kahin se kahin tak nahi hai. Discuss, it is saying ki discuss the scientific aspect of Indian cultural heritage. So for that, first you have to know ki what are the scientific aspect, and you also have to know what is Indian cultural heritage, aur usme scientific aspect kya hai, and then you have to discuss those parts. Theek hai? So not a direct question at all. Fourth question dekhte hain. Describe the salient features of modern art and architecture. Again, modern period se question pucha hua hai. Very direct question. Fifth question dekhte hain. Why Gupta period is considered as the golden age of ancient Indian history? Again, a very direct question. When we study Gupta period, their art and architecture, this term comes ki it is known as the golden age. So, ye bhi hum discuss karte hain. Now, when we compare this paper with the previous three papers of Uttarakhand PCS examination, what we can see is ki there are also some indirect questions as well. इनडायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस मतलब ऐसे क्वेश्चंस जहां पे यू हैव टू अप्लाई योर नॉलेज, आपको थोड़ा सा अपनी थिंकिंग और अप्लाई करनी पड़ेगी. यू हैव टू पंच अबव योर वेट कि डायरेक्टली आप क्वेश्चन आंसर नहीं कर सकते. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिमांड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, एंड इफ यू नो, इफ यू हैव द नॉलेज, यू कैन आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन, बट यू रिक्वायर सम एडिशनल पॉइंट्स ऑल्सो. जैसे ये वाला जो क्वेश्चन है, डिस्कस द साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इंडियन कल्चरल हेरिटेज. फर्स्ट यू शुड नो व्हाट इज इंडियन कल्चरल हेरिटेज, एंड देन यू हैव टू आल्सो नो व्हाट आर द साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट्स इन दैट कल्चरल हेरिटेज. सेम इन दिस क्वेश्चन, डिस्क्राइब द रोल ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट लिटरेचर इन क्रिएशन ऑफ वर्ल्ड पीस. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू नो, यू हैव टू हैव नॉलेज ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट लिटरेचर. सेकेंड थिंग इज हाउ इट विल हेल्प इन वर्ल्ड पीस, हाउ इट कैन हेल्प इन क्रिएशन ऑफ वर्ल्ड पीस. तो यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा आपको thinking apni apply karni padegi to answer the question. So this is what will be our benchmark. Hamara benchmark ye rehna chahiye ki agar aisa question aata hai, because there is a very good chance ki ha pattern change hua hai, to there is a very good chance ki they might ask questions that were not asked previously. So we'll have to be prepared for that. Hame usko uske liye khud se prepare rehna padega. Theek hai? So we have seen already what kind of questions are being asked. Now we'll move on, and now it is time for resources. ठीक है, कि हम पढ़ेंगे कहाँ से, where are we supposed to study the syllabus from. First thing, you have to look at your syllabus. आपको अपना syllabus पता होना चाहिए कि art and culture का ये syllabus है. Now talking about resources, the first resource and the most important resource is NCERT of class 12th by the name of Fine Arts. This is a very short book, less than 140 pages, but you will find most of the syllabus, जो आपका syllabus mention है, most of the topics or almost all the topics can be found in this NCERT. It is written in a very simple language. Hindi, English दोनों में ही NCERTs होती हैं, तो it will be easier for you to understand. And another important thing is there are questions. Once किसी भी chapter के बाद NCERT में you would have seen कि questions होते हैं. So these questions are very important because sometimes they are directly asked in various examination. स्टेट पीसीएस एग्जामिनेशन में मैं डायरेक्टली वो क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं. तो दिस बिकम्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सोर्स. ठीक है, देयर इज अनदर सोर्स, आर्ट एंड कल्चर बाय नितिन सिंघानिया. मोस्ट ऑफ द टीचर्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द रिकमेंडेड स्टूडेंट ये सोर्स को रिकमेंड करते हैं. बट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि यू हैव लेस देन 4 month, आपके पास 3 से 3.5 महीने हैं prepare करने के लिए mains examination में, and art and culture is not the only subject, ये अकेला subject आपका नहीं है prepare करने के लिए, ठीक है? तो reading Nitin Singhania now is not something that will be beneficial, because the return of investment if you are reading this book starting from today is very low, बहुत ही low है. अगर जिन्होंने पढ़ी हुई है, those who have prepared notes from it or those who have studied it very well, that's a good thing. But जिन्होंने नहीं पढ़ी है, I would not recommend कि यार आप start करो आज से art and culture पढ़ना, because that will not be beneficial for you at all. Now coming to the third important resource, which is again a very important resource, not just for this, but for almost all the examination, that is internet. Use internet extensively. आपके पास एक source है, it is a very important source, and internet, अगर आप productively उसको use करते हो, तो it can help you in many, many ways. ठीक है, so these are just the resources. Mostly, I will recommend कि NCERT of class 12, अगर जिन्होंने नहीं भी पढ़ी है, it will take you less than 4 or 5 hours. अगर आपकी reading speed अच्छी है, तो it will take you around 4 and 5 hours. There are only 130 to 140 pages in this book, and it is very easy to understand. So start with this book, at least read this book. ठीक है, so these are the resources. Now moving on, as this is now the role of PYQs and answer writing. Now PYQs and answer writing are very important in any mains examination. Mains examination agar aapko crack karna hai, to you should have knowledge of PYQs. Aapko PYQs analyze karne padenge, previous year questions analyze karne padenge usse, aur you have to write answers. If you are not writing the answers, your chances of acing the examination, the mains examinations, are very low. अगर आप आंसर नहीं लिख रहे हैं, तो बहुत इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू क्रैक द एग्जामिनेशन. सो आंसर राइटिंग एंड पीवाईक्यूज, दे आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इन एनी मेंस एग्जामिनेशन, नॉट जस्ट यूकेपीएससी मेंस, बट यूपीपीसीएस मेंस और एनी स्टेट सिविल सर्विसेज का मेंस एग्जामिनेशन और इवन यूपीएससी एग्जामिनेशन. आंसर राइटिंग एंड पीवाईक्यू, एनालाइजिंग पीवाईक्यू इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है, सेकंड थिंग इज रिविजन एंड आंसर राइटिंग इज द वे. रिविजन, once you start writing answers, you aapne ek topic khatam kiya, you let's say you completed a topic, for example art and culture mein aapne architecture wala topic khatam kar diya, so what you have to do now is you have to revise it and then you have to write the answers. Usse related aapko questions dhoondne hain, questions nikalne padenge, and then you have to write the answers. Answer writing aapka rhythm banayegi, it will, you know, it will make make you comfortable. आप जब exam में बैठे होंगे, तो when you have to write 20, 30, 40 questions, आपको उनके answers लिखने पड़ते हैं. तो if you are writing answer writing, अगर आप practice कर रहे हैं, तो it will make you comfortable. वहाँ पे जाके आपको एकदम से कि धक्का सा नहीं लग जाएगा कि यार what is this, what am I supposed to do. So answer writing, PYQs, analyzing the PYQs, answer writing and revision. So this is the another important thing. So now what should be our strategy for the examination? As we have seen, humne syllabus dekh liya, we have seen what kind of questions were being asked, we have also seen UPPCS mein kaise questions aa rahe the, which we have also set as a benchmark. Yaar hum us tarike se prepare karenge ki UPPCS wale questions ko bhi ace kar sake. Reason being ki format has changed, so we do not know what kind of questions UKPSC can ask in the examination. So what should be our strategy? Strategy, the first thing is you have to complete the syllabus topic wise. हमने syllabus देखा, there were various sub topics in that. Architecture वाला topic है, religion वाला topic है, literature वाला topic है, dances is there, music is there, paintings is there. So there are various different sub topics. You have to complete the syllabus. You have to complete the whole syllabus topic wise. ठीक है, topic wise आपको syllabus complete करना है. Then next you have to revise. Continuously you have to revise. आप रिवाइज नहीं करोगे तो यूर इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू रिटेन द इंफॉर्मेशन. सो यू हैव टू रिवाइज कॉन्टिन्यूअसली. एंड द थर्ड थिंग इज डेली आंसर राइटिंग. सो दीज आर द थ्री पिलर्स ऑफ योर प्रिपरेशन. किसी भी, दिस इज नॉट एक्सक्लूसिव टू आर्ट एंड कल्चर, ये सिर्फ आर्ट एंड कल्चर के लिए नहीं है, फॉर ऑल द अदर सब्जेक्ट्स ऑल्सो दिस इज, दीज थ्री आर योर इंपॉर्टेंट पिलर्स. फर्स्ट, टॉपिक वाइज यू हैव टू कंप्लीट द सिलेबस, यू हैव टू एनालाइज द होल सिलेबस. आपको टॉपिक वाइज उसको पढ़ना है, उसको देखना है. सेकंड थिंग, यू हैव टू कॉन्टिन्यूसली रिवाइज. आपको रिवाइज करना है, रिविजन करते रहना, अदरवाइज यू वोंट बी एबल टू रिटेन व्हाट यू हैव स्टडी. एंड द थर्ड थिंग इज यू हैव टू राइट आंसर्स डेली. डेली आंसर राइटिंग करनी है. दिस हैज टू बी योर स्ट्रैटेजी, नॉट जस्ट फॉर आर्ट एंड कल्चर, बट फॉर ऑल अदर सब्जेक्ट्स एज वेल. दिस विल this is the only thing that will help you in acing the examination. So this has to be your strategy. Now, how can we help you? हम आपकी कैसे help कर सकते हैं? We at Oracle IS, we have already started our module for UKPSC mains. Our classes have started for a few subjects and we'll be starting other classes very soon. So our classes, they are conducted in both online and offline mode. There is a fixed number of classes as per the weightage of the subject. जितना weightage है subject का, उसके basis पे हमने अपनी classes design की हुई हैं कि हम इतनी classes per subject हम लेंगे. And that is mostly to save the time of the student. कि student ज़्यादा time अपना waste ना करे किसी एक subject में. तो उसकी वजह से classes have been, there is a fixed number of classes and they are both in online and offline mode. Obviously, the recordings of these classes will be available to you also. Second thing is notes and revision. Now, बहुत सारे बच्चे ऐसे होंगे आप में से जिन्होंने नोट्स प्रिपेयर कर रखे हैं, वेल एंड गुड, बट देर आर मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड नोट्स. बहुत सारे ऐसे होंगे जिन्होंने अभी तक का नोट्स प्रिपेयर नहीं किए हैं रिगार्डिंग मेंस. सो वी विल हेल्प यू विद दैट. वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड नोट्स दैट आर एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर यूकेपीएससी मेंस एग्जामिनेशन. मेंस के पर्पज से ही शॉर्ट, वेरी शॉर्ट एंड प्रिसाइज नोट्स हैव बीन प्रिपेयर्ड बाय ओरेकल आईएएस. दीज नोट्स विल हेल्प यू इन फर्स्ट सेविंग योर टाइम. अब आपके पास इतना टाइम नहीं है कि आप नोट्स भी बनाओ, आप आंसर राइटिंग भी करो, आप उनको रिवाइज भी करो, ठीक है. सो टू हेल्प यू विद दिस प्रॉब्लम, वी हैव ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड नोट्स व्हिच विल हेल्प यू इन सेविंग द टाइम. नाउ द नोट्स आर वेरी क्रिस्प, दे आर वेरी प्रिसाइज एंड दे आर स्पेशली, दे आर एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ यूकेपीएससी मेंस एग्जामिनेशन. द थर्ड थिंग दैट वी आर डूइंग इज डेली आंसर राइटिंग एंड इवेल्युएशन. आई हैव ऑलरेडी एम्फसाइज्ड, मैं ऑलरेडी बोल चुका हूँ आपको कि आंसर राइटिंग कितनी इंपॉर्टेंट है किसी भी एग्जामिनेशन, मेंस एग्जामिनेशन के लिए. सो डेली आंसर राइटिंग सेशंस आर बीइंग कंडक्टेड इन द क्लासेस एंड इवेल्युएशन. नाउ दिस इवेल्युएशन वाला पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वाई? बिकॉज दिस इवेल्युएशन विल हेल्प यू इन इम्प्रूविंग. आप आंसर लिखेंगे, आप उनको इवेल्युएशन के लिए देंगे, तो इट विल हेल्प यू इन improving your answer, आपकी answers की quality improve करने में it will help you. So this is how we at Oracle IS are going to help you. We have classes अगर आपको attend करनी है, you can attend the classes in both online as well as offline mode. We have notes prepared for you to save your time, कि उससे आप revise करो आप class में जो भी पढ़ रहे हो. And then third thing, you will write answers daily. So this is how we are going to help the students who are preparing for UKPSC mains examination. So in this video we discussed art and culture, uska relevance kya hai is examination ke purpose se, what is the weightage of art and culture in the examination, GS1 ka part hai aur uska kitna weightage, what is the expected weightage as per previous examination ke basis pe humne dekha ki expected weightage kitna hai. And we have a strategy ki we have to give a limited number of time and prepare well for this examination. If you have any query regarding this, you can mention in the comment section or you can just send a message to this number that is going on in this. Okay, so this is all about the strategy video of art and culture. I wish you all the best for your upcoming examination. Thank you.